Today, we are back at Regent's Park for Frieze Sculpture 2024. Now, I've been coming to this event for the past couple of years, and it's always such a pleasure to see how the landscape transforms with new works of art. It's a perfect mix of nature and creativity, especially when the autumn sun hits just right. So join me as we take a look at the highlights of this year's collection. Oh, and make sure you stay with me till the end, as I got a little bonus for you. We'll also be heading over to Trafalgar Square to check out the new Fourth Plinth installation. All right, let's go. Well, welcome back to my channel. I'm your host, Ken. Now, I'm not an art critic by any means, but I do enjoy coming to the Frieze at Regent's Park every year. There's nothing like enjoying art in one of London's most beautiful parks. Anyway, enough chit-chat, let's start with our first piece today, which is The Dancer by Leonora Carrington. At first glance, you can definitely see the figure in mid-dance. But as you look closer, the torso resembles something more otherworldly, almost like a bird or maybe even a lizard with wings and a tail. It's fascinating how she blends these forms together. Despite being made from rigid bronze, it actually feels so full of movement, like it could take flight at any moment. But next, we've got the Duet, created by Fiesta Gaze. According to official notes, this installation honors the legacy and world-building capabilities of ceramics. To me, actually, these two pieces look like they are in conversation with each other, but I wonder what they're talking about. Now over here, we have Ennui Head by Yoshitomo Nara. What a massive head it is. The oversized head has this melancholic contemplative vibe, although the name Ennui Head suggests it's actually more about boredom or apathy. It's intriguing how a single expression can evoke such different feelings depending on how you look at it. And behind me, you've got Pillars. It's made up of two towering structures of brightly colored ceramic pills, everything from vitamins to painkillers. It's positioned on either side of the path, almost like a portal. Maybe it's a comment on how pills can be both helpful and overwhelming, depending on the context. The way they tower over you definitely gives off a sense of their power. So next up, we have Afterwork and its companion piece, Untitled. These works supposedly explore the idea of labor and free time and how they intertwine. Afterwork actually reminds me of those flat sticks in golf courses. Untitled is a sculpture of reclining figure representing the human form in space. Over here, we have Lightning Rod. It's a seashell-like sculpture surrounded by stones that were collected from Dorset. This piece has this sort of natural energy to it, like it's connected to the nature. Now this one is called the Ghaf Tree by UAE artist Mohammed Ahmed Ibrahim. It's a fiberglass sculpture inspired by the Ghaf, a tree that's known for its resilience in the desert. It has this strong, almost indestructible look. It's a perfect symbol of resilience and sustainability. But Mohammed Ahmed Ibrahim also have another piece in the park, which is called the Form. But next, we have a sculpture called Bambatha First, which is basically a self-portrait of the artist Muholi. It's a figure trapped in a mass of tubes. Muholi says it's about their struggle with fibroids and gender dysphoria. But it also feels like a metaphor for feeling trapped and suffocated by life. One of the most talked about pieces this year is Ant's Non-Earthly Delights. This installation consists of three physical sculptures and two augmented reality experiences. After admiring the physical sculptures, make sure you scan the QR codes near the sculptures. So there seems to be a virtual sculpture appearing on the screen against the backdrop of the park, and it shifts between different states of completeness before exploding entirely. the artist's semi-transparent hand can also be glimpsed on the screen as well, as if it's extending into the landscape itself. By the way, if you've been enjoying this tour with me, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and ring the bell so you don't miss out on more of my travel and art adventures. Another unusual piece this year is the Materials of Mind Theatre. This piece includes 25 stoneware sculptures that resemble costumes, arranged on a platform that acts as both a stage and a pedestal. On certain days, the 9th, 10th, and 12th of October, there will be live performance, when a performer replaces one of the sculptures, turning it into a living, breathing piece of theatre. Well, over here, we have a text-based sculpture called I Don't Have Another Land. This piece is part of the artist Nathan Coley's ongoing series. The words were sourced from a graffiti that Coley found on a wall in Jerusalem in the early 2000s. The next sculpture has a very interesting title. It's called Steadfast, Step Into Me, Allow Silence to Create the Sounds You Desire Most. Yes, all lowercase. It's a strange mix of scrotum flower, oversized chicken feet, chunky legs, and lipstick. It's truly one of the most fascinating pieces in this year's collection. Next, we have Sea and Earth. These two figures here represent mythological characters that come out of the sea and from the earth, engaged in a sort of silent dialogue. It's one of those pieces that makes you think about our connection with nature. But here, we've got a sculpture hanging from the tree called What Will It Take For Us To Awake? It's a bronze bell modeled on the color lily. Now, I've given you a taste of what Free Sculpture 2024 has to offer, but there's so much more to see. If you're in London, make sure you head down to Regent's Park before 27th of October to experience it for yourself. It's free and it's a perfect way to spend an afternoon surrounded by art and nature. Now, on to the bonus part that I promised to earlier. Let's head over to Trafalgar Square to check out the newest installation of the iconic Fourth Plinth. Welcome to Trafalgar Square. This is the latest and the 15th commission for the Fourth Plinth, called Milvete Zun Instante, or in English, A Thousand Times in an Instant, by Mexican artist Teresa Margolis. From a distance, it mirrors the rectangular shape of the plinth itself. But as we get closer, we can see there's so much more happening here. The sculpture actually references a zompantli, a wooden rack once used by Mesoamerican civilization to display the skulls of sacrificial victims. But Margolis has reimagined it in a way that carries deep modern significance. It's made up of plaster casts of the faces of 726 trans, non-binary, and gender non-conforming people from Mexico and the United Kingdom. And every single one of these casts were handmade by Margolis, and each cast took up to an hour and a half to complete. So you're looking at over 1,000 hours of work that's gone into creating this piece. What's even more interesting is that the sculpture is made from plaster, a fragile material that will slowly deteriorate as it faces London's wintry weather. But that's intentional. The gradual erosion of the piece is symbolic of both the vulnerability and resilience of the trans community, fragile yet enduring. It's a powerful message, isn't it? So that's just about wraps up our tour of Free Sculpture 2024, as well as the new Fourth Plinth installation. I hope you enjoyed this walk through art and nature. As always, I'd love to hear your thoughts. Did any sculpture stand out to you? How did they compare to last year's ones? Drop me a comment and let me know. And if you missed last year's free sculpture, check out this video next. Or if you are up for more art and travel content, here's one recommended by YouTube. Either way, I will see you over there. Until next time.